we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section real analysis, and this problem is based on the concepts of one-one, onto, and continuity of functions. And this question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section C. The problem is, let f be a function from the closed interval 0, 1 into the open interval 0 to 1. Which of the following statements are false? Which of the following statements are false? Options. Option 1. If f is onto, then f is continuous. Option 2. If f is continuous, then f is not onto. Option 3. If f is 1 to 1, then f is continuous. Option 4. If f is continuous, then f is not 1 to 1. We have to identify which of the following statements are false. We have to identify the false statements from the following. Okay. We now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. We have the function f, and let us take the statement that is given in option 2, that is, if f is continuous, then f is onto. Is it true or false? So we are given a function f from the closed interval 0, 1 to the open interval 0, 1 is continuous. Note that 0, 1, the closed interval, is compact subset of R. Why? Because this is a closed and bounded subset of R. And who are the compact subsets of R? They are the closed and bounded subsets. Therefore, the closed interval 0, 1 is a compact subset of R. Now, what is f? F is continuous. F of a compact set is compact. Why? Because the continuous image of a compact set is compact. Therefore, f of 0, 1 is compact subset of R. So f of 0, 1, that is the closed interval 0, 1, that is the image of the closed interval 0, 1, must be a closed interval. Why? Because the image is compact. So therefore, f of the closed interval 0, 1 is also a closed interval, that is a comma b, say, contained in 0, 1, note that the containment is proper. And we see the elements from 0 to a and union, the elements from b to 1, that is, the open interval 0 to a union, the open interval b to 1 have no pre-images. Therefore, f is not onto. So thus, if f is a function from a closed interval 0, 1 to open interval 0, 1 is continuous, then f is not onto. Then f is not onto. Therefore, the option 2 is true, but we have to find out the false statement. We have that given function. Let us take the statement that is given under option 1. Option 1. That is, if f is onto, then f is continuous. Given the function, and it is given that function is onto. Because it is onto, the image of the closed interval 0, 1 is the whole of the open interval 0 to 1, because it is onto. But we assume that f is continuous. Assume that f is continuous. Now, as discussed in the earlier option 2, since f is continuous, 0, 1, the closed interval is a compact subset of R, and the continuous image of a compact set is compact, and thereby f of 0, 1, the closed interval is compact, and thereby the open interval 0 to 1 is compact, which is a contradiction. Thus, our assumption is wrong. F is not continuous. So then, f of the closed interval 0, 1 is compact because the closed interval 0, 1 is a compact subset of R, and we have the continuous image of compact set is compact, therefore this is compact. So this will imply the open interval 0 to 1 is compact. This leads to a contradiction. Therefore, our assumption is wrong. Therefore, f is not continuous. So f is not continuous. Thus, if f is a function from the closed interval 0 to 1 to open interval 0 to 1 is onto, then f is not continuous. Therefore, the option 1 is false, and it is one of the answers for us, because we have to identify the false statements. We continue in the next slide. Option 3. The statement that is given in option 3 is, if f is 1 to 1, then f is continuous. Is it true? We show that it is not true by giving a counterexample. So we have that function which is 1 to 1. So we will now construct a function which is 1 to 1 but not continuous. So define a function f from the closed interval 0 to 1 to open interval 0 to 1 by f of x is a piecewise function, and that is defined as x by 3 plus 1 by 4 if 0 less than or equal to x less than 1 by 2, x by 2 plus 1 by 3 if 1 by 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. Obviously, this is a straight line in this interval, and this is also a straight line. And obviously, this function is 1 to 1. This function is 1 to 1. It's very easy to see that. And I will show you how it is. Note that f of x, that is the image of f of x, will belong to when x is equal to 0, 1 by 4. When x is equal to 1 by 2, it is 1 by 6 plus 1 by 4, that is 5 by 12. That is the closed 1 by 4 to open 5 by 12 union. 1 by 2, when x is equal to 1 by 2, 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3, that is 7 by 12. And when x is equal to 1, 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3, that is 5 by 6. The closed interval 7 by 12 to, comma 5 by 6. That is the union. So the images will lie in this, and this is contained in the open interval 0 to 1. Agreed. This is 1 to 1. It is very easy to see that, and it is very easy to prove it. How? I will show you. Claim f is 1 to 1. So let the case 1. Let xy belongs to the first interval, that is 0 to half, closed at 0 end. And x not equal to y. Then when x not equal to y, x by 3 not equal to y by 3, that will imply x by 3 plus 1 by 4 not equal to y by 3 plus 1 by 4, adding 1 by 4 on both sides. That means, so what is this? This is f of x, and what is this? This is f of y. So this will imply f of x not equal to f of y. So when xy belongs to this first interval and x not equal to y, then f of x not equal to f of y. There it is 1 to 1. So 2 is a similar argument. We can extend in this interval half, the closed interval half to 1 when x not equal to y. We can, by the same similar argument, f of x not equal to f of y. In this also it is not 1 to 1. And suppose we take x belongs to the first interval and y belongs to the second interval, x not equal to y. Obviously, x belongs to the first interval means f of x belongs to 1 by 4 to 5 by 12 and f of y belongs to 7 by 12 to 5. Obviously, they are not equal. So that will be the, and these are two disjoint ones, and f of x not equal to f of y. In any case, x not equal to y will imply f of x not equal to f of y. So this says, thus f is 1 to 1. So the given function is 1 to 1. And if you see its continuity, it's continuous everywhere, looks like. It is continuous everywhere except possibly at x is equal to 1 by 2. So we will discuss the continuity at 1 by 2 by discussing its left hand limit and right hand limit. We will see that in the next slide. So that's what we have. That's a 1 to 1 function. Now we discuss continuity of f. Notice that the limit extends to 1 by 2 minus, that is the left hand limit at 1 by 2, that is 5 by 12, that is 5 by 12. And the right hand limit when x tends to 1 by 2 plus f of x is 7 by 12. And obviously they are not equal. Therefore, f is not continuous at x is equal to 1 by 2. So thus, the statement that is given in option 3, if f is 1 to 1, then f is continuous, is false. And we have to identify the false statement. Therefore, the option 3 is false, and that's among one of the answers for us. Lastly, get into the fourth option. If f is continuous, then f is not 1 to 1, not necessarily. We will give a counter example. So we give a continuous function which is 1 to 1, which is 1 to 1. So we define a function f of x is equal to x by 2 plus 1 by 3, and note down f of x that belongs to the closed and bounded interval 1 by 3 to 5 by 6, which is contained in the open interval 0 to 1. And it is obviously a straight line, and it is continuous, and it is not, it is 1 to 1. It is 1 to 1. Clearly, it is continuous on the closed interval 0 to 1, and it is 1 to 1. 1 to 1. So, thus, the statement that is given in option 4, if f is continuous, then f is not 1 to 1, is false. So this is one of the answers what we want. Therefore, the option 4 is false. So finally, our answer is, the false statements are options 1, 3 and 4. Because we want to identify the false statements. So this is our final answer. So that is the discussion of the solution of a problem from the section real analysis, and the question is based on, you know, 1 to 1, unto, and continuity of functions. I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem. Go on working out some more problems on these lines. I wish you all the best. Thank you.